Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, June 5th, and the title for today is An Issue of Worship. All through sacred history, the Lord constantly had to deal with those who fell into idolatry and other forms of false worship. See Matthew 4, verses 8 through 10. In the final crisis, as depicted in Revelation 13, the issue of worship will again arise. Here, too, God's people will have to make a choice about whom they will worship and serve. In week two, in the lesson titled Daniel and the End Time, we studied the story of three Hebrew boys who were ordered to worship the golden image in Daniel 3:5. We saw too how Revelation 13 uses language from the chapter depicting in the persecution that God's people will face in the end times. This is, we may see what happened in Daniel 3 as a precursor to what will happen in the last days as depicted in the immediate context of the beast powers in Revelation 13. All who were commanded to worship the golden image, or they would be put to death in a fiery furnace. Similarly, in Revelation 13, whoever would not worship the image of the beast is to be killed. Revelation 13, 15. Babylon has always been the capital of false worship. The Tower of Babel testifies to its builder's desire, like Lucifer, to ascend above the heights of the clouds, as well as to the efforts to save themselves in case of another global deluge. Thus, they refuse to believe in God's promises never to bring another flood upon the earth. Genesis 9, verses 8 through 11. The Neo-Babylonian Empire likewise exalted the work of human hands. Nebuchadnezzar extolled the great Babylon that I have built, Daniel 4:30. Later, King Belshazzar took the golden cup to Solomon's temple for a feast, and they drank wine and praised the gods of gold and silver, bronze and iron, wood and stone, Daniel 5:3 and 4. Notice that the true vessels of the temple were filled with the intoxicating wines and deadened the sensibility of all who drank from them. As a result, many in the city perished when Babylon fell. An outward appearance of truth can deceive us by disguising the deadly wine of Babylon. False worship and false ideas are the currency of Satan's kingdom. How can we make sure that we are involved in any kind of false worship now? Please answer in the comment sections below. Thank you for watching, and make sure you share this video with all your friends and family. God bless you.